Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, March 23rd, 2011. It's a little after 9 a.m. on the East Coast, and last time I looked, stock index futures had dropped below fair value, so we are looking for a little selling at the open on Wednesday morning. Both crude oil and gold are up in the pre-market, and that could help those sectors on Wednesday. Now, looking at the Japanese market, overnight we were down on the day. We came down. We actually traded through the previous day's low, but did not close there. So we're still finding resistance right around the open gap, which is now officially closed, but still is acting as resistance. Now, the open gap on the Australian market, we haven't got there yet. We've traded up to the upper channel line 2 days in a row, but have not closed above it. So the Australian market is still on a sell signal. The German market, is not updated. The German market was still open when I made this chart. The DAX was actually up about 15 points last time I looked. And so given that it was down 35 points the day before, we're still trading. It was probably another inside day for the DAX. So we're still trading below the top of the open gap. So we've got a lot of overhead resistance in the markets around the world. Looking at the S&P 500, we're stuck at 1300 for 2 days now. We've been trying to break through and have not been able to do so. So we're going to be watching 1300 very closely. Now, we're pinned in between the 50 and 100-day moving average, 100-day at the bottom, 50-day at the top. And so the market's watching these levels closely. If we can break out above 1300, then we should be able to go up and retest the recent high. Taking a look at the major indexes that we follow, starting with the VIX. The VIX had a very quiet day yesterday, and that's quite unusual. Volatility hasn't been that quiet for weeks now. I'll have to go back to the lows of February before you'll find a quiet day like we had on Tuesday. A close above 2401 would give us a new buy signal for the VIX on Wednesday, and that, of course, would be supportive for lower stock prices. Now, the Dow 30 did not close above the upper channel line, so we're still on a sell signal. We're still on a sell signal for the S&P 500, and the breakout point has now dropped below 1300. The NASDAQ 100, no change here. No change for the Russell. The small cap stocks are still outperforming large cap stocks right now. So we've got the Russell and we've got the Zacks Microcap Index both on buy signals. Bank stocks, nothing going on there. A lot of news out about Citibank. We had a very volatile day on Monday. Still on a sell signal for this stock. A daily close above 455 is needed to give us a new buy signal. No change for cloud computing, no change for Cramer's Mobile Internet Index, no change for credit card stocks. We're right on the edge of generating a new buy signal on Wednesday. Looking at energy stocks, we're still on a buy signal, no change there. Looking at the XAU for gold and silver stocks, we're on a buy signal. We're seeing a lot of upward momentum in silver stocks over gold stocks right now, but a couple of the big ones are having trouble with the open gap. So we need to close above 36.22 to give us a buy signal for Pan American Silver. We're on a daily buy signal for Silver Wheaton, but again, having trouble getting through that open gap. A daily close below 40 would change that. Looking at the SOX index, no change here. We're still on a sell signal. Uranium stocks, we've come back to the bottom of the open gap for the index. Some of the individual stocks are doing better than that. UEC is up at the top of the open gap. We need to close above 457 to give us a buy signal on Wednesday. We're on a buy signal for URRE. We need to close below 192 to generate a sell signal. For URZ, we're looking for a close below 334. We're on a fresh buy signal here. And we're on a new buy signal for USU. Close below 461 would change that on Wednesday. Now, all of these stocks are going to have trouble getting through the open gap resistance, but if they do, they should do very well. But anytime that you have that open gap, you have to respect it, and you can certainly see that that's what the market's doing for these stocks at the present time. Taking a look at bonds, no change here, no change for the US dollar, no change for the euro. The euro is up testing previous highs. We've got the US dollar down testing previous lows. Anytime you have support like this or resistance like this, you have to respect it until it is either broken or the market reverses. There's no guessing here. You just have to wait and see what happens. Taking a look at commodities, no changes here. We're on a buy signal for copper. A close below 56.24 would change that. We're on a buy signal for gold on the GLD. A close below 137.44 would change that. 33.89 for the SLV. For gasoline, we're looking for a close below 47.49. 40.35 for crude oil and 10.54 for natural gas. Looking at Wednesday's roadmap, we're right in the flypaper channel. We're stuck here in the 1300 area. We now have a new early warning signal up there, and you can see that we started to trade south, and we have a little red on the chart there. For the 60-minute right side chart, an hourly close below 1293.18 on Wednesday would give us a new intraday sell signal on Wednesday. Looking for targets to the downside, we're at the top of an open gap. The bottom of the open gap could potentially act as support, and then 1281.25 would be our next trigger to the downside. If we can start breaking out above 1300, then 1312.50 is our next target to the upside. And watching the VIX, if the VIX starts trading above 2069 on an hourly basis, that would tell us that we should expect downward pressure on the rest of the stock market. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.